we're back with CCKC. I am Mikey, and with me I have two special guests. We have Kunle, the president of the Association of Nigerians in Nova Scotia, and Nakin, the treasurer of the Association of Nigerians in Nova Scotia. Thank you guys very much for joining me.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mikey. It's good to be here.
Perfect. Do you guys want to tell me a little bit about yourselves and what your jobs entail within the association?
My name is Kunle Fakiyesi. I am the president of the Association of Nigerians in Nova Scotia. And I have with me my colleague here.
My name is Akitunde Odeni. I'm the treasurer of the association.
So today we are here to talk about Nigeria Week 2018. Nigeria's independence anniversary comes up on the 1st of October every year. And over the past few years, the Nigerian community here in Halifax and Nova Scotia as a whole has grown significantly. So this year, the association is putting up Nigeria Week 2018, the second annual edition of Nigeria Week. And we have a lot of fantastic activities lined up for this year's Nigeria Week 2018.
Definitely. I was taking a look at it, and some of these events really look appealing for a lot of people. One of them is actually about, I went to school next to the African Nova Scotia Museum. I actually went to school, there's a chair, Graham Crane Junior High. I actually went to that junior high right there. So I've been there multiple times.
That's awesome.
So also, what is the best part about this Nigeria Week? Like what is it that not only appeals to Nigerians, but also everyone else? What do you want to get everyone else there involved?
Well, that's a very tough question. Because the theme for this year's Nigeria Week is actually building bridges for a united people. So for that week, we have a lot of interesting and educational events that are lined up. For me as a person, the week runs from September 30th to October 6th. We have events every single day. It's very hard for me to pick out the one that's really the most fun. But if I were boxed into a corner, I would say Nigeria Night.
Yeah.
Because Nigeria Night coming up on the night of Saturday, October 6th at Dalhousie University Student Union Building is the grand finale. Mm-hmm. And we have a lot of, you know, it's going to be a very classy dinner event. Tickets are on sale. You can visit our website, www.nigeriansinnovascotia.org, to buy your tickets. We are instituting the first ever Distinguished Nigerian in Nova Scotia Award, which will be given out on that night. We are also instituting the first ever ANNS Bursary Award, specifically for students. You know, students from NSCC, St. Mary's University, Dalhousie, and the rest of them are welcome to apply for that bursary award. For me, I would say that's like the best part of it for me. I'm sure Akintunde will have his favorite part.
Yes, to add to that, for someone like me, I would rather say soccer. Nigerians call it football.
Football, over here we call it soccer, yeah.
And you know, it's a footballing nation, one of the best countries in the world as regards football, FIFA competitive activities. So the football competition is coming up on the 30th of September, between the hours of 4 p.m. till 8 p.m. in the night. It serves as an avenue where Nigerians in Nova Scotia can come around and celebrate. You know, it's gonna be fun. We are planning 4 matches, you know. Different teams are coming up, and it's a family event, so we look forward to receiving as many Nigerians and even Africans generally in Nova Scotia to support this event. It's going to take place at BMO Soccer Stadium at Clayton Park. And apart from that, if I'm asked to choose, it's like you rightly said, it's a week-long activity.
Yeah.
You tend to look at which one is my favorite. On Sunday is the Thanksgiving prayers in church around Nova Scotia, churches around Nova Scotia, and it starts from Sunday, September 30th, and it runs through till October 6th. It's a week-long activity, but I would rather go for the soccer. I like football. It's apart from the fact that you are playing football with your colleagues, it's a fun, a means more or less like an exercise.
Exactly.
Recreation, yeah. And the events are all open to not only Nigerians or Africans, but as a matter of fact, everyone in Nova Scotia, as long as you live here and you can make it to any of the events, please feel free to do so.
Perfect.
From the soccer competition on the night of Saturday, September 30th at BMO Soccer Center, 4 p.m. to 8 p.m. The very next day on Monday, October 1st, we have a talk show and symposium, and we have a lineup of very interesting and experienced speakers coming out, and they will be talking about the topic of business and employment, challenges and prospects. For the new immigrant.
Exactly.
And that's a topic that actually speaks to a lot of people. It doesn't matter where you come from. It's either you want to build your career or you want to launch your business, right? So we have specialists that are coming from places like iSands. We have financial professionals that are actually responsible for assessing loan applications that will be coming to speak to that topic. And that will take place at the Canada Game Center in Clayton Park from 5 p.m. to 8 p.m. And that's just two of the events.
Exactly. Like they said, that's just two of the events.
Two of the events.
Keep listening. We're going to take a short break. And when we come back, we're going to find out more about these events and some great things, guys. Keep listening to CCKC.
88.9 The Platypus.